is time for Clubhouse, and I'm so glad that you guys were able to join me today. We have had an exciting day already. I just want to be sure, can you guys hear me? If you would put over there in the chat if you can hear me, that would be helpful. We are kind of having, we had a little technical difficulty here just before we got started. So, Luke, are there folks there who can say that they can hear me in the chat? It would be helpful to know that if we have any troubleshooting to do. Isn't technology fun? I tell you what, when we all first started going to Zoom for classes, the first class that we had here on Zoom was a little, oh good, Lynette says she can hear us loud and clear. Pat, hey, from Pat from Wisconsin. Lynette, you're in San Diego, good. I'm so glad you guys can hear me. So yeah, I was saying that first time that we had a Zoom class, so this was what? So COVID shut us all down like in March of 2020. And so like in April, I think we had a class and it was one of those, what the heck is Zoom? And how are we gonna teach? And surely this will all be over really soon. Maybe we shouldn't even have a class. And we wound up, we had to like reboot, the internet went down in the middle of class, and oh my gosh. And it was just so, I was thankful for the students that we had in class because they were just like, oh honey, yeah, no problem. Reset the internet, we'll be here when you get back. So, you know, quilters are just the kindest, nicest folks around, and your all's patience is always a blessing. So I'm glad that you can hear me. And I have so much that I want to talk to you about today. And we have a great lesson. We're doing the year of the rulers, all different rulers all year long. Last year we had the year of the grid. And I tell you what, if you have an idea of something that you want us to cover here in Clubhouse during our educational portion, could you put that in the comments? Because we are starting to kind of think forward to 2023, believe it or not, and kind of figure out what it is that we want to chat about. This is your time really to kind of chat and learn about whatever you want to learn about, and I'm happy to teach whatever it is that you want to learn about. Let me know over there in the comments what it is, and do put where you are watching from. So I know that we've got folks from Maine and Wisconsin, and normally we've got our friend from South Africa who shows up as well. So pop in there and just say hello to us and tell me where you're from. And then I also want to know, so today is my birthday. And I have definite opinions about birthday desserts and what birthday dessert I want to have on my birthday. But I want to know from you, for your birthday, put over there in the chat, over there in the comments, what is it? What specifically is it? Is it red velvet cake? I like red velvet cake. Is it key lime pie? I really like key lime pie. Is it just a wonderful chocolate chip cookie? Like what, or is it traditional like white cake or yellow cake with chocolate frosting? So when it's your birthday, what is your celebration birthday dessert? Put it over there in the chat because I am going to go get something today. I don't know what it is. It'll probably be one of those cupcakes from the Bundt Cake place. They're so good, yeah. So put over there in the chat and let me know. And Luke, as people put down what their favorite birthday dessert is, let me know what that is as well. So so for my birthday, we have a lot of announcements that are centered around the celebration that we're doing for my birthday. And so I want to tell you about that here in a minute, but I also want to make sure that you are on our Quilted Joy newsletter, because when we do have events like the celebration of my birthday or any other event, sales or educational events or downloadable worksheets, if you are on our newsletter, that will appear in your inbox. So make sure that you're signed up for our newsletter. And just I would also say, if you would just reply back to the newsletter and just like say hello, that helps the Google and Bing and Yahoo and AOL controllers in the sky decide if we go into your inbox or if we go somewhere else that's, you know, hard to find, like with the, you know, the sheets that are on sale or something like that. So if you just reply back, that will tell your email provider that you want to talk to us, and they'll put us higher in your email newsletter box. it's kind of crazy, all the little things you have to go around to make the robots in the sky believe that you're not a robot too. I never thought that I would grow up to be proving to a robot that I'm not a robot, but it seems like most of the day I spend proving to a robot I'm not a robot. So make sure you sign up, and then we will have a live chat on September the 21st at 1 o'clock Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific, and we'll have that in both the Quilted Joy Clubhouse on YouTube as well as the Quilted Joy Clubhouse on Facebook, in our Facebook group. And that's just to chat about whatever you want to chat about. I mean, we chat about anything. We chat about whales and casseroles, and kittens, but we also chat about loading a quilting machine or different feet so that you can applique on your sit-down domestic machine more easily. So whatever you want to talk about, just come to on September the 21st. That's a Wednesday, and we'll just chat about whatever you want to talk about. All right. Do we have anybody say what their favorite desserts were? What?
Yes, we do. We had a lot of pies.
A lot of pies. A specific pie or just any pie?
Boston cream pie.
Oh, no, I've not had a Boston cream pie. I think that's like a vanilla custardy thing. I don't know anything about Boston cream pie. Okay, what else?
We have some angel food cake.
Angel food cake with fresh strawberries. And oh, there's, yeah, that's pretty good. Yeah.
Two more. Yeah. We have a German chocolate cake.
German chocolate cake. See, okay, here's the problem with German chocolate cake for me. It's the coconut part. Like, I will happily drink coconut rum, happily. But actual coconut, it's the texture. It's like a peach, the peach fuzz, the skin of a peach. Ooh, heebie-jeebies. Same with coconut.
You gotta toast the coconut.
Toast the coconut?
Before you make the icing is the way.
Oh, instead of raw?
Oh, yeah.
Toast it like in a toaster oven?
No, she would just toast it. She toasts it in her oven. She makes it
toast it in the oven.
She makes it for all of my dad's birthdays. And
it's the dad birthday.
We may only have the cake that he serves us.
Oh, yeah. The rest of it is his cake. Mm-hmm. Yeah, with a toasted coconut. What else?
The winner goes to Cynthia Woods.
Cynthia?
Ohio,
in Ohio?
Your favorite dessert.
Which is?
Red velvet
cake. I agree, Cynthia. It's really, and it has to be the real cream cheese icing. Like, you can't, it's all about the icing. Like, the cake is good. It is truly all about the icing. Yeah. Any others?
Lemon pound cake.
I have had like a lemon bundt cake. I'm guessing it's kind of similar. And then of course at Starbucks, they have that lemon cake that you can get that is very similar to the pound cake consistency. That's also very good. I would probably put blueberries on it. I bet you do too. That sounds really good. Okay. All right. So obviously I haven't had lunch yet. So for my birthday, I'll figure out something. I'll go get a cupcake or something tonight to celebrate my birthday. But I did get a super big birthday present today, and really it's all because of you guys. So it's a thank you to you, and then I have a little reward for you as well. So today on my birthday, we found out that we won two awards in the Reader's Choice Best of 2022 awards. Now get this, we won Best Independent Quilt Shop in America. Yeah, can you believe that? Wah! And I won Best Quilt Designer in America. And that's the Reader's Choice Awards for 2022 from Love of Quilting. So super exciting. And so to celebrate, we're gonna give you a 15% off coupon for Glide thread. So all Glide thread, 15% off. We have never done this, you guys. We have in the past had smaller sales. We've never had a sale like this. So 15% off, the coupon code is BEST. Now, if you were on our newsletter list this morning, you were notified of this coupon code, and there was a snafu with the code. So it was not working up until about a half hour ago. But through the magic of the internet, we got it working. So I apologize if you tried to place an order this morning with that coupon code and it didn't go through. It is working now. So 15% off all Glide thread. That includes Glide thread bundles. So if you are a Kimberbell fanatic and you love the Kimberbell thread bundles, those are all 15% off with coupon code BEST. So that's to celebrate the Best Independent Quilt Shop Award. For the Best Quilt Designer Award, we also have 15% off all of my patterns and all of my kits. Okay, so you can get the Flamingo Stampede Kit, 15% off. You can get the Bluegrass Jamboree Kit, 15% off. You can get the Nocturnal Forest Kit, 15% off. You can also get all of my digital patterns. So if you have a computerized long arm machine, all of my digital patterns are also 15% off. And that includes all of the pattern sets as well. So the pattern sets would have not only an olive edge to edge, but also borders and corners and sashings inside of them as well. So there's so much on sale, and I do apologize if you tried to use that coupon code earlier, but check it out. It's 15% off all Glide thread, all Magna Glide bobbins, all Glide 60, all kits, all Glide bundles, all Kemperbell bundles, and then all Angela Huffman patterns, kits, and quilting designs. So happy birthday, right? And thank you guys so much for voting for us. Really, that is your all's doing. And I can't tell you how much I appreciate you blessing my little business and my team with your love. We sincerely appreciate all of your support and help and guidance into allowing us to serve your needs in the best possible ways and to grow. And your support really does help us do that. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, then we also have our September thread bundle that just launched, and that is good for September only, and that's the Forest Fay thread bundle. And again, if you use that coupon code, you'll get 15% off this month's bundle. So that is Forest Fay. Now I will say that that code, BEST, it will end on September 11th. So it's good for now, September 7, 2022, through September 11, 2022. So you have a few days to use it. So plan accordingly, right? It's gonna be a very short sale because it's a deep, deep discount that we have not done this deeply in the past. So those three colors on the Forest Fay thread bundle is nickel, Oxford, and parsley. And they are just absolutely gorgeous together. They just sparkle and they complement each other. They're a really nice grouping of those three blocks. All right, did we have any other desserts that popped up, Luke, that people were saying is their favorite for birthday celebrations?
Michelle gave a long list.
Michelle had a list? All right, Michelle, that's awesome. That's my kind of pie. A husk cherry pie. Pies win over cakes. You know, I can kind of agree with that. The only thing I don't like is when I was a student at Indiana University, they would serve apple pie with a slice of cheddar cheese on it. I don't know if that's an Indiana thing. Like, I don't know where that comes from. And I can tell you that in Kentucky, we don't do that. So I don't know where the cheese on the apple came from, but that's the way they served in the dorms at IU Bloomington, and I was having no part of it whatsoever. But I love a good apple pie, just keep the cheese off of it. So Michelle had a long list, huh? Good for you, Michelle. All right, we are going to talk today about circle rulers. Now, we have talked about a lot of different rulers this year. Circle rulers are not a beginner ruler, so I want to make sure that when you think about circle rulers, that there's lots of different sizes, and anything over 3 inches, you will be using the outside edge of the circle ruler. Anything under 3 inches generally is sold as an interior template, where you are working inside a hole and you're pushing the hopping foot along the exterior of that hole. You're tracing the exterior of the hole versus a, Jesse, can you take this one? So this one is bigger than 3 inches. And so when you work with this kind of ruler, you're going to work along the outside edge. And there are so many designs that you can do with a circle ruler. We are going to be looking at how to use a circle ruler for block designs. Now, I will tell you that we have worksheets with loads of designs for circle rulers. We're just going to be talking about a block design. So if you're looking for those downloadable worksheets, we have them over in our Learning Center on the quiltedjoy.com website. So if you go to Quilted Joy and you go over to the Community tab, you'll find the Learning Center. And we have lots and lots of great, helpful educational articles in there. One of them is about all different kinds of rulers, and there's downloadable worksheets with step-by-step instructions for how to create different designs with different shapes of rulers. And there's one that is specifically about circle rulers. So let's look at circle rulers for a block design is what we're gonna do. Now, to draw this on the computer is super duper hard. So I'm not gonna draw it on the computer. I'm actually gonna draw it on paper. And so we've just got a setup here that's a little bit different for us. So I'm hoping that this works out. Jesse, I'm gonna go over here. Can you see it okay?
I can, yeah.
Okay, all right. So the thing about using circle rulers is you kind of want to plan things out ahead of time on paper. Because what you have to remember is that your hopping foot is going to add a quarter of an inch around the whole exterior of this ruler. So it's not like I can go grab, you know, a 3-inch ruler and it's going to give me, and if I, you know, trace this on paper to kind of audition a design, that's how it will stitch out. It will not. It will actually stitch out, you know, the needle is actually going to be a quarter of an inch away. And so this little gadget right here, this is a drawing wheel. And the drawing wheel is just a simple piece of plastic with a hole in it. And the drawing wheel, the reason it's helpful is that it'll add that quarter of an inch away from the outside edge. If you have done any garment making, you've likely seen a wheel like this before that will add a different size. Generally, it's like a 5/8 inch size or something to the outside of a garment pattern. For quilting, we use one that's a quarter of an inch because that will show us what that hopping foot will actually eat up, the space it'll eat up as we're working around it. So I'm going to place my needle. In this case, it's my Sharpie in the dead center of my block, and I'm going to put my ruler along this horizontal line. Now, in real life, don't use a Sharpie on your quilt, right? You're gonna use chalk or some kind of marker, and you're gonna mark your north and south and your diagonal lines to give you the proper registration for your block. So I've got my needle in the fabric, and I have my circle, and I'm just gonna go around that circle. All right, so let's see what that did. So there's one circle. So these diagonals and these north and south are chalk, right? But this just gives you a sense of what this is gonna look at. And I really truly would draw anything you're gonna do with circle rulers on paper first before you take it to the machine, because things will bend on your brain. You'll need that audition time to kind of get to know that circle ruler. Okay, I've got my needle back in the center of the block. I have my my ruler aligned. I'm gonna go back around that circle. All right, let's see how that does. So if you notice, what I'm doing is I'm placing the circle along, this was along the east-west line. This was along the north-south line. And I'm actually using the lines on the ruler to align. So I'm gonna move this off into the pink area here. Can you see that line okay, Jesse?
I think so. Okay.
So there's a line that's etched. This is the Pro Circle ruler from Lisa Calle. She is one of my quilting heroes. She's a fantastic instructor. If you ever get a chance to take a class from Lisa, do it. She's wonderful. And so this is her circle ruler. This is a 3-inch Pro Circle ruler that I'm using here. So I've got the etched line, the horizontal line that she has on her ruler along the horizontal line that I have marked on my block. And now I'm just gonna go around. I've placed my needle in the center position of my block, and now I'm gonna go around the next area back to the center. All right, and so there's three, and I have one more left to do. Again, I would have left my needle in that center position on my block. And if you have any questions about this, put this in the chat and Luke will let me know what your questions are. All right, and that's the design it would give me. Isn't that lovely with the it's almost like an orange peel, pumpkin seed look in here. So that was just with four. And we only use the north, south, east, and west to align our circle ruler. All right, I wanna take this one little step further to just show you how easy it is to get a really complex design just out of a circle ruler. So we used it on the north, south, east, and west. Now let's go around and use it on the diagonals. So I have my needle back in that center position of my block. I have my ruler now on a diagonal. And now I'm going to go around my ruler and back to that center. Okay, so there's one. Now I'm going to go on this diagonal. Are you seeing it okay?
Yeah, we're doing good.
Okay, good. All right, I'm going to go back around this ruler and back to my center point. And then I'm going to put it on this one. And I know it's a little hard to see with my little fingers in the way. Okay. And now I have one more to go, and that's this diagonal. So I'm going to put my needle is back in the center. I'm going to align my ruler. And there is the design. Isn't that gorgeous? And that's simply from aligning that horizontal line that's etched into the ruler along these marking lines. And so you can get stencils that actually give you this whole pie shape that you can pounce on. You can also just take a ruler and with some chalk just give you, you know, the halfway point, so the north-south line, and then from corner to corner to give you those diagonal lines. So that's the fancier version, and believe me, there are ways to make this go even fancier. And we used a fairly small ruler to do this. This is a 3-inch. I'm gonna grab on the machine so that we can take this to the machine, and I have a slightly larger one. This one is Lisa's Pro Circle 4. And so let's just do this on the north-south so that you can see what the stitches out, what it looks like. So I'm going to place my needle in the center position. I'm going to go needle up, needle down. And of course, I have my ruler foot here on my millie. And I'm just going to take some little tacking stitches and leave it in the needle down position. I'm going to nest the ruler up against the edge of the hopping foot. I'm going to align that horizontal line against that horizontal line I have marked on the fabric. And then I'm going to hold it with as many fingers as I can spare. And I'm going to go around. And when I hit that horizontal edge, I'm going to stop with that needle in the down position. And I'm going to switch my hands. And then I'm going to keep on trucking back. And I tell you what, I'm going to stop right here only because I want to cut those threads that are in the middle so I don't trip on them. All right, now I'm going to head back to the center and I'm going to stop. Okay, there was one circle on the west side. Now I'm going to go to the north side. Again, I'm going to knock it up so that I'm against the edge of the hopping foot. I'm going to align the horizontal line along the north-south. I'm going to hold it with as many fingers as I can spare on my non-dominant hand. I'm going to stop right there and move my hand just because the camera's kind of in the way and go back to the center. All right, now I'm going to head down this one. And Luke, let me know if there's any questions that we get about this technique. I'm going to stop on that equator, move my hand. I'm going to come right back up to the center. And now I have one more to go. Knock it up against here. And I'm going to come around. I know my hand's in the way. I'm going to stop here at the South Pole and move my hands for you. It's kind of hard to stitch with a camera and not block it. Okay, there we go. So there's that circle design. And I tell you what, I'm just going to bring my thread up and I'm going to move the camera around so that you can see what that looks like. Yeah, pretty. Let's dress this up just because I think it'll be fun. So let me bring my bobbin thread up just so I don't trip on it. And on this, I'm using my APQS Millie to stitch. I'm going to actually turn on Quilt Glide, which is a secondary form of stitch regulation. Some machines call it Cruise or Coast. On an APQS machine, it's called Quilt Glide. And I'm just going to fill that negative space out with some stippling. And when I get up here, I'm going to stop for just a second so I can trim off my tails here in the middle, in the center of my block. And then And then I'm going to come on back. and then I'm going to go to the next one. And so I'm just putting in a micro stipple. So think about a wandering path in the woods. Think about Casper the Friendly Ghost. Think about a dog bone shape, like whatever. Just have something in your brain, because if you don't have something in your brain, the little monkey brain will take over and then you can't, it's hard to remember what the heck you were doing. You'll go squirrel and then you'll completely lose it. You could even switch out the color here to a different, like a variegated or a gold color. It would be gorgeous. Right now, this actually, what I'm using is a fatter thread. This is a, it's like a 35 weight. It's actually an omni thread and it has a matte finish, but this would be gorgeous in a thread that has a sheen to it. Okay, so here's the end result. Now, that's very different than a more simplistic looking, right? Than the one, Jesse, can you take this camera back again? Than the one that we did here on paper, which was just going around it more, and it was a smaller circle too. So play with it on paper. I would say if you can, and we have these drawing wheels on the website, so you can get those drawing wheels, but if you're gonna get a circle ruler, I would go ahead and get a drawing wheel with it so that you can play on paper first. Luke, were there any questions?
I don't have any questions.
Surprisingly, no questions. All right, very nice. Okay, well, if you do have questions that come up, put them there in the chat and we'll come to it later. All right, and I just wanted to spend a little time to thank our sponsor, APQS. APQS long arm machines are 100% handcrafted in Iowa. They are loved the world over and they have a lifetime warranty. If you or someone you know is interested in an APQS machine, you can give us a call here at quiltedjoy.com or you can contact your local APQS store, your local APQS dealer, or visit APQS.com. So thank you so much, APQS. We appreciate you. All right, I have a wonderful sewing tour to show you. This is Blaire's sewing room, and she keeps her Millie in her basement studio, but you are gonna love her basement studio. All right, let's take a look. Hey, Blaire, how are you?
Good, how are you doing?
I'm good, thank you so much for joining me. Where are you located, Blaire? What state are you in?
I'm in Rhode Island. I'm in the village of Kingston, Rhode Island, which is right across from the University of Rhode Island.
Fabulous. And are you in your home? Is your studio in your home or is it in a particular part of your home?
It is. I'm lucky enough that I have almost my entire basement. I have
Wow.
Since I've gotten my Millie, I've moved into all of the space in the basement that was finished.
Awesome. Well, I can't wait to see how you have your studio laid out. Blaire, could you turn that camera around so that we can take a tour?
I'm in my basement. My basement was finished when we bought our house. It's completely finished in what they call knotty pine. And it was originally, when our kids were younger, it was partly my sewing room and partly their kind of hangout with their friends' room. The space is 26 feet wide width, and it's about 14 feet the other way. And I have some built-ins that were here previously to me moving. Yeah. I have my design wall on one design wall. And then you'll notice that I love closet organizers and bins and things like that. So this is where I keep, this is where I keep all my current projects that I'm working on and my scrap saver system. I have some windows. This cutting counter was built for me by my husband when I owned a quilt store.
Oh.
1993 to 1998 in Connecticut. And I have several of them, but this is the only one that I kept for my own studio because I obviously couldn't keep all of them.
Yeah, very nice.
Kind of see my sewing, where I sew in the background area.
That's where your piecing is back in there?
Yep, I can walk
through. Yeah.
This is my fabric cabinet that my husband made me.
Lovely.
30 years ago. And I think his hope was that I would stay in it in terms of fabric that I owned.
Right. Yeah.
But then I opened a quilt store, so that didn't really work. So sure. I'm going to move a little bit.
Uh-huh.
This is one of my favorite pieces. It's one of those ironing stations that you make with one of the rolling carts.
Yeah.
So that I can just roll it around if I need to do it for piecing or move it into another room. But
yeah, that's very nice.
Favorite things. We made that ourselves.
Uh-huh.
I have two machines set up here. I have a fast, and I have a little Janome that I take for traveling.
Awesome.
I have just recently the cabinet in front of me. We had a death in the family, and I inherited from them. It's a Singer 9115, which I've had restored, which is in this cabinet down here. I haven't quite worked it in yet.
Cool.
And then I have another, that's my sign for my quilt store that I use.
Wonderful. All right. And I hear you've got a long arm. I can't imagine. Well, mm-hmm. I guess you have the whole basement, so you could, yeah.
We're going to walk right that way right now. This is
awesome.
Over to my long arm room. I also have a bathroom down here, which is nice.
Very nice.
And then this is the space that I'm currently using for my long arm.
Oh, that's perfect.
It used to be the teenager's bedroom.
Yeah.
So when the kids became teenagers, they got to have the room downstairs here.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just going to walk this way. So I keep all of my organizational stuff over here and my my supplies for my Millie and et cetera.
Uh-huh.
Go the other way.
And is it a 10-foot millennium, a 12-foot? What size is it?
12-foot in a 17-foot wide space.
Perfect.
So.
Yeah.
And then if I just back up kind of the corner, you can see I have storage. I have a little bit of thread at the end because I don't have, I'm new to Millie, so I don't have a lot of thread yet.
That's fabulous. What a great space you have, Blaire.
It is a great space. When I got my Millie in January, this was set up as a bedroom. And you can see, I love what, because people can see this is real rough here. Even had a closet, which we tore up.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. Yeah, you did. You reclaimed that space and you certainly needed it.
Yes.
You're putting it to good use.
Right. I knew I had the space. It was just, our kids are grown. We had four bedrooms set up and I was like, why?
Yeah. Well, Blaire, do you have three things that you would suggest to your bestie? They don't have to be quilt related, but three things that you're interested in right now?
I do. Well, one thing I was going to say is if you look at this wiring on the wall, I got all of that wiring free. And there's an organization called Buy Nothing. And if you Google it, you can join a Facebook page to your particular local community. And when you want to get rid of things, you put them out there for people if they want them. You know, think children's clothes that they've grown out of. Or you can ask for things that you need. And we've gotten rid of a lot of stuff ourselves, but somebody was getting rid of four closets worth of closet organizers. And I got it all for free.
Fantastic. Love that. So, all right. What else?
Two, as I do bullet journaling. And if you don't know what bullet journaling is, you can Google it, go on Facebook. But it's instead of buying a date bookkeeper that's like, you know, for the year 2022, you take a blank journal and you make it your date book for all the things you want to track. And I track all of my quilting for myself, for the long arm, you know, camping, gardening, everything in there, because we retired in 2019. And I found because we retired and we had so many things to do, I had to schedule them to get them all done.
Yeah. Yeah. Way to keep yourself organized.
Third thing is I would say to people to try to do quilt projects where you are forced to run out of fabric, because I think people, I'm a weird quilter. I don't buy pre-cuts. I don't buy fabrics for a particular class. I don't tend to buy patterns. And I like the challenge of running out of fabric because it makes you shift what your original design is and the quilt just becomes. So that would be something.
Yeah, you like that challenge. Other people would be in a ball in the corner twitching a bit because that would give them anxiety. Well, can you turn your camera around, Blair, so we can see your smiling face?
Sure. I'm going to back off a little so you don't see me too close.
Thank you so much for showing us your space, Blair. If people want to connect with you online, where can they find you?
I have a Facebook group for my small business, which is very small. It's just starting. It's called A Link in a Chain Quilting. I don't have a website right now, so that's the best way to find out kind of what I'm doing.
Fabulous. Well, Blair, thank you so much for spending a little time with us. I love your basement studio. My studio in my old house was also in my basement, and it just felt like, you know, my space that I could be free and nobody would like bug me and I could just have fun on my own. So I love basement studios.
It's great. You just close the upstairs door and you're on your own in world.
There you go. All right, Blair, we'll see you in the clubhouse. Thanks so much for your time.
Well, thanks for visiting.
Okay. All right. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you so much, Blair. I loved your space. I especially love that you have a hubby that creates things for you and makes things for you to keep you organized. You are a lucky, lucky woman, Blair. If you would allow me to get on a video chat with you, I would love the opportunity to do a looky-loo of your sewing room. So there's a place that you can go and sign up to volunteer for that. We do record that earlier, so no pressure. When we record it, you know, if you mess up or say something you didn't mean to say, we just stop and start over again. So absolutely no pressure at all. You just need an internet connection, and then we can spend about 20 minutes chatting, and I can be nosy and find out how you have your sewing room organized. So you can sign up there at that link. So thank you very much, Blair. All right, I wanted to tell you about some new arrivals that we have here in the shop. One is we just got every color of Kimberbell 45-inch, 44-inch width, regular quilting cotton. So Kimberbell Basics line, they do it in the different seasons. So there's the fall, winter, spring, and summer season. And we have every single color that they make now up on the website that you can purchase. So we also have a number of solids that we're bringing in. They're painters select. Did I say that right? Painter's palette. And then we are also getting some of the shabby line, that's Riley Blake, as well as loads of other lines, including the Water Babies line that just walked in. So the Water Babies line is adorable. It has little crabs on it. It has little whales and it has jellyfish. It is adorable. And we also have the Water Babies kit and the Water Babies panel. So do check that out. And then finally, if you have a long arm quilting machine and you have not yet taken a look at the Sew Tights magnetic sewing bars, take a look at that product. And on the product page on the website for the magnetic Sew Tights, there's a video that shows you how to use them on a long arm frame. And it's just a very different way of loading to a frame that's kind of cool. So check out, that's a new product on the market that I think you'll enjoy. So check that out. And then I did want to ask you if you are enjoying the clubhouse, I would ask you to review us over on Google. That helps the Google machine know to serve us up to others. And I do read every review that people post on there. And I thank you so much for your time to do so. Of course, the best possible compliment you could give us would be to share this with someone that you know who might find it interesting and helpful. Also quilts. So I would love for you to share us, and if you would leave us a review on Google, that would also be quite helpful. All right, so in the Quilted Joy Clubhouse on Facebook, each month we ask folks to submit a photo of an unquilted quilt top, and then I select one of the photos to show how I would quilt it if it were my quilt. All right, so the quilt that I chose this month is Christine's quilt. Isn't this gorgeous? Christine, I don't know if you're watching, but if you are, if you would put the name of this pattern in, because I just love it. Love, love, love your pattern. And don't you especially love, let's just take a moment here to appreciate Christine's color choices too, how stark and dramatic it is with the white and the black, and then just that kind of burning, reddy, purple, batiky color in the middle. Love, love, love your piecing, Christine. Love this quilt. So think about how you would quilt this if it were your quilt. Now, we have already talked about all those circle rulers earlier, And I want you to notice that in this space that we have here on Christine's quilt here, I want you to notice that she already has given us those needed diagonal lines. So all I would need to do to put some kind of circle block design in this space would be to chalk out my north-south and my east-west line because my diagonals are already there. So once I have my registration lines, I would go through and I would do that same design that we looked at today, which was to put my circle here and a circle here and a circle here and a circle here. So that same design that we did, I would put it in here. Now, it's hard for me to do circles freehand. So what I've done, Christine, is actually put this in the computer so that you can see. So see, isn't that much better? So that's the design I'm talking about, where it gives you that interior kind of orange peel negative space. All right, so Christine, when we do this all the way around, that's what I'm talking about. Isn't that dramatic and nice? All right, so Christine, the next thing I wanted to look at where kind of framing it out as it goes in. And I just can't, you can't ignore the strong arc that you have here in the piecing. And what I really like to do, Christine, is to take that strong arc and you're gonna need to find a ruler or you're gonna need to mark it. And this is what I'm talking about, is I wanna make this shape and draw that out all across the quilt. Now I'm gonna do this again. It's kind of hard for me to draw arcs easily. So I just want to sketch this out and then I'm going to show you where I've drawn it and taken more time. But that's the shape, Christine. That's what I want to kind of pull out to frame this out. So let me show you what I'm talking about. So there's that one ellipse. And notice your ellipse. It goes into this nine patch that you have that's kind of on point. So let's show you what all of those look like. So there's all of your ellipses. And then I would not ignore these outside borders. I would do the same thing on the outside border. So I would do the same ellipse. Let me get here. That same ellipse on the outside border as well. Okay, so now what I've done is I've created this negative space inside that area. And so this is that same, see, I've already got my diagonals in here, and then here's my north-south. So I'm ready to go as far as putting that same, repeating that same circle design. It's just on here, I would only get half of a circle, right? Because I've got the edge of the quilt here, and then half the circle, because I've got that edge of the quilt here. And I would have that now go all the way around. So let me just turn that one on. Border ellipse. Let's see, right here. So I've got all my circles there. Now let's talk about these areas here, these cross areas here. And what I really like to do is kind of, I've got a lot of circles, I've got a lot of arcs on here, Christine. So I wanted to play it off with some straight lines. And so what I thought about doing was if I can just go from here up to here and then go around that block and out. My little computer is saying, no, there it goes. And back and around and out and back and around and out and back and around. And that way I'm creating this cross shape, this straight line shape behind all these ellipses. Okay, so I wanna show you what that looks like, Christine. So let's go through and that's what it looks like. So this is how I would quilt your quilt, Christine, by using those circle rulers and only doing four, but using your existing piecing lines to give me the registration marks. As far as those large ellipses, you're gonna need to find something, and I would probably mark those, because likely what you're gonna need is some kind of, like look around your kitchen even, a pot lid or something to give you that long ellipse. So look around and you may find something in your kitchen that'll work. But this is how I would quilt your quilt, Christine, if it were my quilt. Now, Christine, you quilt your quilt however you want to quilt your quilt. But I would love to see what you come up with. So if you, when you get it done, if you would post it over in the Quilted Joy Clubhouse so that we can all cheer for you and see what choices that you made and how you decided to quilt your quilt, I would love, 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 love to see it. So I thank you so much for submitting it to me so that I could play on it. And we did have a lot of folks who submitted their quilts on in the Quilted Joy Clubhouse this month. So I did want to celebrate some of those quilts that we saw. So here's some show and tell of some finished quilts that we found in the Quilted Joy Clubhouse there on Facebook. Isn't this gorgeous? Christine, your feathers are beautiful. But now think about how intimidating this would have been for Christine as far as all that negative space behind these beautiful blocks. And look at the choices that she made with just a simple kind of wavy line echoing around all of those shapes. Really great choice, Christine. I especially like how you just did kind of a, it's like a daisy with little petals coming off all the way around some of those blocks. And then that inner red border, you used ribbon candy. Really nice, effective. Great job, Christine. She says this was the first time playing with rulers on her domestic sewing machine, and that it was a little harder than she thought. Well, Christine, I would not know it. You did a really great job. All right, this next one is Barbara. And Barbara, she says that it's a combination of custom and an interior pantograph. So along the deer, on that panel, she used an all over edge to edge, and then she did custom quilting on all of those borders coming out from around the deer. And she says that it's not computerized. She just did a quilting inside that panel, and she used the pantograph curly maple. And then in the border, she did chevrons and ghost arrows, and they all point to point in the diamonds, and some freehand oak leaves. Nice job, Barbara. I can tell you had some fun there. I really like how you pulled those arrows out in that negative space. Nice job, Patty. I love this, Patty. Patty, she said that a couple of months ago, she sent in a picture of this quilt hoping that it would get picked for the How I Would Quilt It segment on our clubhouse, and it did not get picked. But other viewers in the Quilted Joy Clubhouse gave her some suggestions, and she just looked at it in super small sections and quilted those sections. So this is the result. And she says that she's glad, Patty says she's glad to have quilted it and gotten the binding on. And Patty, I think you did a fabulous job. I really love it. You had fun. You know, you can tell when somebody's having a good time through their quilting, and I can tell you had a good time, Patty. Thank you for posting that. Tammy, don't you love this? Look at all those crows. Love it. And look at the spider webs that she did. So Tammy says that she did this for a customer. It's called Ravens, and she freehand quilted those spider webs. Tammy, super effective. Really great job. Very Halloween-y. I like it a lot. Thanks, Tammy. And then this one is from Rebecca. Don't you love a simple like red and white quilt? It's so calming to me. I really love it. And Rebecca, I was distracted at first by that stained glass window with the sewing machine that you have there in the window. That's gorgeous. I would love to see your sewing room, Rebecca. It's really nice. She says this is complete and it's ready for shipping. It's gorgeous, Rebecca. Thank you so much. And this one was posted by Tammy. And Tammy says this is geraniums and it's for her client, Bonnie. And it's not complete yet as Bonnie needs to add the frilly flowers to the ends of the stems. So notice those stems. So thankfully, she did not put those 3D elements on first, because if you put a 3D element on, it's a little hard to do any kind of long arm quilting on it. So she kept the frilly flowers off, she quilted it, and now Bonnie will put those flower heads on. So nice job quilting that for her, Tammy. Good job. And then Yvette posted this one. So in the last clubhouse, I think it was the last clubhouse, I looked at the chandelier pattern and how I would quilt a chandelier pattern. And this is another way to quilt a chandelier pattern. And Yvette posted this. Now take a moment and just appreciate Yvette's curved crosshatching in those setting triangles, and look at her feathers all the way around each of those blocks. Just absolutely gorgeous. Yvette, thank you so much for sharing that with me. It was fun to see. All right, well, I want to invite you to join us next month on October the 5th at 1 o'clock Eastern. 10 a.m. Pacific for our next Quilted Joy Clubhouse. And we are going to look at French curves and different ways that you can use French curves in your quilting. So there's some specialty rulers that we're going to get into next. We've kind of covered some of the basics, and we're going to talk about some specialty ones. And again, if you have an idea of what you want to talk about in 2023, I am all ears. Like, let me know, because we're trying to plan it out now. So do join us on social media. We are on Facebook. You can join our Facebook page at Quilted Joy, where we post announcements, as well as when we have folks come in and they rent time on our machines and they quilt their quilts, we'll post some fun shots there. And then join us over on Instagram, where we have more of the kind of the day in the life, behind the scenes kind of look. And then of course you'll find us over on YouTube, and we have a lot of different tutorials, as well as all of the past Quilted Joy Clubhouse recordings are all up on YouTube. So you can get sick of me over there. So go over there and watch the past recordings. And then of course our Facebook group at Quilted Joy Clubhouse, where it is full of the kindest, nicest quilters on the planet. And if you have a question or just want to share and want somebody to hold you up and cheer for you and celebrate your finish, then join us over there in the Quilted Joy Clubhouse on Facebook group. And then don't forget, we do have that Ask Me Anything that's coming up on September the 21st, and that's at 1 o'clock. Now, I'm about to head off to Denver to record the next season of Love of Quilting, the PBS television show that I co-host with Sarah Gallegos. And so I will be sharing some of the things that happened on September the 21st as we chat there in the clubhouse and on YouTube. All right, you guys, thank you so much for joining me, and I hope you have a wonderful day. And don't forget, you've got that 15% off coupon for all Glide Thread bundles, all Kimberbell Glide Thread bundles, all Angela Huffman patterns, all Angela Huffman kits, all Angela Huffman downloadable digital patterns. It's all there. The word is best. That is the coupon, best, and it's good through Sunday, September 7. All right, I'll see you guys later. Thanks so much. Bye.